great wisdom of King Solomon, how the Queen of Sheba paid him a visit and was so impressed with him, his court, and his servants, and what he had done as King of Israel, she bestowed upon him in the kingdom many good gifts. She also marveled at his wisdom and insight and his devotion to the faith. But today we hear another side of King Solomon, how in his old age he became careless and began worshiping false gods. You know, Solomon was reported to have hundreds of foreign wives, and in trying to please them all, he built up shrines to their various gods around Jerusalem and the hills. And this angered God, who decided to punish Solomon. But God chose to reserve that punishment for Solomon's successor. So the punishment would result after Solomon's death in the division of the kingdom that was never really reunited. Isn't it true that we are all a bit like King Solomon? You know, in our better moments, we can do wonderful things that are pleasing to God. We can be very faithful and fulfill God's will for us. But there are also moments when we do just the opposite. We wander from God. We're unfaithful in certain ways. We get distracted and we turn our focus away from God to other matters of concern. In a sense, we are all like ancient Israel, divided between obedience and disobedience, between fidelity and infidelity. Yet in spite of our flawed nature and our divisive personalities, God is merciful and kind. And we know this from the way Jesus treated sinners. In the gospel, we hear about a foreign woman, a pagan really, who approaches him and begs him to heal her daughter. And after some reluctance, maybe to test her faith, Jesus agrees and heals her daughter. So the fact that Jesus would be attentive to the needs of someone who regularly worships other gods, that's good news to us. It tells us that the Lord is always willing to extend his hand to bless us, even when our hearts might be far from him. Christ is truly generous and kind in sharing God's love and mercy. Even if we call out to him in our sinfulness, he responds. And I think this message applies not simply to the way God is generous with us, but the way we should treat other people. The fact is, you know, we tend to reward faithfulness from our family members and friends. We heap blessings upon those who are pleasing to us. But how do we treat people who are not faithful to us? How do we deal with friends who might betray us? How can we show compassion to people who are not so pleasing to us? So that is really the difference between God and us. God is able to hear the cries of mercy even from those who may not really know him. God is able to overlook and to forgive the sins of people so that all can enjoy his favor. Can we do the same thing to other people? When we learn to treat everyone with compassion and love, then we will truly be